Hello! In this video, I want to talk about the spin Hamiltonian of magnetic dipole-dipole interaction of two spins. In my previous video, magnetic dipole-dipole interaction in NMR and EPR, I have described major ideas which I use to construct such Hamiltonian. Basically, I have derived the formula which gives the energy of interaction between two magnetic moments, mu1 and mu2, separated by a distance vector r. This energy is equal to mu0 divided by 4p multiplied by the r to the power of minus 3 and multiplied by an expression in parentheses, which is scalar product of mu1 and mu2 minus 3 multiplied by scalar product of mu1 and r multiplied by scalar product of mu2 and r and divided by distance vector squared. It is more or less clear how to use this formula in the classical case. One needs to specify three vectors, mu1, mu2 and r, which are enough to perform computation of energy via this formula. In quantum mechanics, the usage of this formula is a little bit more complicated. First of all, we have to account for a quantum mechanical nature of particle magnetic moment, which is proportional to the particle angular momentum. If electron or nuclear angular momentum originate from its spin described by the spin operator, which is a product H S, where H bar is the Planck constant and S is the vector spin operator metric, then the magnetic moment is the product of the zero magnetic ratio gamma multiplied by the spin operator. Using this formula to describe the magnetic moments of the first and the second spin, we can construct the Hamiltonian operator for two interacting spins via magnetic dipole coupling. We insert the expression for mu1 and mu2 into the above expression for the energy and obtain the Hamiltonian, which is equal to mu0 divided by 4 pi multiplied by gamma 1, gamma 2, h bar squared divided by the distance vector to the power of 3 and multiplied by the expression, which is very similar to the expression which was in the parentheses in the expression for the energy above, and with only one difference, that the magnetic moment are substituted with the spin matrix operators S1 and S2. Okay, let us think now how we can use this Hamiltonian. If we have, for example, two electron spins, then we can construct the spin matrix for the first electron as a product of a vector spin operator with a unity matrix, where vector spin operator S contains three Pauli matrices Sx, Sy and Sz as components. With this, we can write the S1 operator as a similar expression we obtain for the S2 spin operator. Hence, S1, the vector spin operator, as well as S2, vector spin operator, is a set of 4x4 matrices. When S1 and S2 are inserted into the Hamiltonian, we will also obtain a 4x4 matrix. This matrix of the Hamiltonian can be used to determine the energy level of the system. However, knowing just each matrix numerical value is not very useful for the analysis and characterization of the spin-dipole interaction. In order to have a more useful Hamiltonian presentation, I will make some transformation which explicitly demonstrate the role of the parameters which enter the Hamiltonian expression. In order to perform this transformation, I will express three components of the distance vector r, rx, ry, and rz, via the angle theta and phi of the spherical coordinate system. As usual, rx is equal to r sinus theta cosine phi, ry is equal to r sinus theta sinus phi, and rz is equal to r multiplied by cosine theta. Now I will insert this expression into the above Hamiltonian. Also, I will write the scalar products which are in the Hamiltonian explicitly. It will give me. To continue, I will express the spin operator as x and as y via the rising and lowering spin operator as plus and as minus. These formulas enable me to establish the following relation between the products of the spin operators. Now, we can rewrite the Hamiltonian in the following form. We obtain an Hamiltonian which contains many product terms. It is important to put these terms into the separate groups. First of all, we separate the terms which contain the products of the spin operator S1z and S2z, which I mark with yellow color. This allows me to rearrange the Hamiltonian in the following form. To continue, I will express the cosine phi and sine phi function via the corresponding exponential functions. By inserting the expression for the cosine phi and sine phi into the Hamiltonian, I can present the terms which are in the curly brackets as a sum of six different terms A, B, C, D, E, F. This form of the spin dipolar Hamiltonian is sometimes called dipolar alphabet. The term A we know already. It is proportional to the product of S1z and S2z. The term B is characterized by its independence on the angle phi. The term C is proportional to the exponent of the minus I phi. The D is complex conjugated term C. The term E is proportional to the exponent of minus 2 I phi. And the term F is the complex conjugated term E. The obtained spin dipolar Hamiltonian in the form of the dipolar alphabet can be handled more easily in many cases. For example, if we have two spins with quite different gamma 1 and gamma 2 in a strong magnetic field P, then only one term A from the dipole alphabet is enough to describe the interaction of such system. The total spin Hamiltonian of such system, including spin-Zeeman interaction of both spin, is equal to such expression. Since the operator S1z and S2z are diagonal, the obtained Hamiltonian is also diagonal. It allows us to determine very easily the energy levels of this system and the photon frequency for the transition from the quantum state with one energy to another. Here I would like to inform you that there is another my YouTube video with the title Peak Pattern Doublet NMR and EPR Spin Dipole Interaction Spectrum, where I show how to determine the shape of the spectrum for the system with such Hamiltonian. With this, I would like to finish and thank you for watching.